How can you create a better aging report in Power BI? Something that looks like this. Now let's see where we're starting from. Now aging report is a great report for data sets like this. In this case, we have work orders, but it could be anything else which has kind of a start date and an end date or a finish date. But of course, some items in this case, or some work orders, are still incomplete. So those dates are blank. And we just need to get an idea of how old are these things. Were they pretty recent or are they from really long time ago? Now you could do that in a simple table like this. Now this is showing you the total open orders, great. And it's showing you a distribution and it's showing you that most of them, as you can see, the big numbers are from the recent months, but there are some from, who are pretty old as well. But we could show it so much more beautifully in Power BI. We could create a report like this, which not only shows you the high level numbers at the top here, we're seeing the open orders, we're seeing the average order age in days, but we're also seeing a really beautiful distribution by their age in days. And if you were zooming in that, you can see that, zero, more than 50, more than 100 days and so forth. So you see that beautiful distribution. And of course, once you have that, you can do with Power BI what only Power BI can do, which almost looks like magic to me still, which is you can dive deeper into it. So you can say, hey, show me what's going on with these ones which have been open for a long time. So I'm holding down the control click to select that. And then maybe I'm sitting down with the person in charge of the Germany division, maybe the sales or the manufacturing unit, and I can just hold down control and click Germany again. And now I know exactly which issues I need to talk to them about, right? So we can say, hey, let's focus on serving Carrie, Sabrina, Larry. They have orders from Germany which are open for a long time. Again, just an example, but you can see what's possible with Power BI with a relatively simple report. And frankly, that's what I love about Power BI. It's the simple stuff. Yeah, there is a complex stuff, but it scares me just like probably it scares you. But I love that so much is possible with something really simple. So let's see how we can do this. Now, if you are a Power BI beginner or still feel like a beginner, then this channel is for you, my friend, so make sure to subscribe and click that bell so you are notified whenever I answer your Power BI questions. Now, this question comes from our Learn Power BI member, Paolo Damiani, and Paolo and I discussed this issue where he was working on for his client. And if you are interested in asking questions, well, all you have to do is go to learnpowerbi.com/question. So let's start building the solution, but before that, let's start where I always like to start, which is in the model. So model is the heart of Power BI. Trust me, this should take at least 80% of your focus, not the visualization. Visualization comes easy if you have the model right. Now in this case, our model is pretty clean, it's all set up, and we're really focused on the work order table. Now both the data table and the lookup tables are important, but in our case, for solving this purpose, pretty much we can focus on the work order table itself. By the way, if you have no clue what I'm talking about, data table, lookup table, then check out my Power BI tutorial, which now has, I think, more than 4 million views. Big thank you, my friends. All right, so now that we have seen the data, let's look at the work order data itself. Now, this is shown in Power BI. Just to make it easier for me to explain it to you, I put it in Excel as well, just as dummy data. So imagine we have the work order number, which uniquely identifies a work order or a specific item. And then we have some kind of a start date, and then we have complete date. Now, of course, we're focused on these items, which have the complete date as blank. And think about it, then how are you going to calculate the age of these items? Now, we could do is I could say, oh, well, I'm just going to take today's date and minus the start date, and that'll give me the age. But of course, you notice that this isn't quite right. And you can see that these items are actually not open, so they should not be counted. So of course, we're going to have to do something a little more sophisticated, and we're going to do, we're going to say if this is blank And I think that's how you do blank in Excel. I feel more comfortable in Power BI now than that, right? So if it is blank, then it is open, then let's calculate the age. Otherwise, just leave it, right? So again, sometimes I do this in Excel and I call this the human learning. I always say that human learning comes before machine learning. So before I can teach Power BI something, I gotta learn it myself, and I often break it down and step by step. Now, the odd thing is that that's what you need to learn and master Power BI. People think that, oh, I'm not smart enough. Actually, I think, at least that's what works for me, I need to dumb it down. I need to break it down like small, simple steps, because that's how Power BI works as well. So yeah, you need to dumb yourself down. All right, I'm getting carried away. So let's come back here, and of course, where are we going to do this in is in the query editor. Now, of course, some of you may be thinking or asking yourself right now, hey, shouldn't we create a measure for this? You probably should, but this is the easier approach. And since this video is at least focused on the beginners, I'm going to show that to you. At the end, we can talk about the measure approach in a bit. All right, so here we are in the work order table, and we have the order start date and order complete date. So to add a column, we're just going to go to add column over here, and then I'm just going to click custom column. All right, there we go. Let me zoom in. So for custom column, I'm going to call it age. And here, so I need today's date, which is date.from datetime.local now. And that is today's date. And of course, I can do minus. Hold on, guys. Okay, and I'm going to find that column and I just double click on that. Oh, it was right there. So minus start date. But again, remember, we had a test in Excel. We had to check that, you know, we wanted the completed date to be blank. So I'm going to add the same check here. So let's go back in again, and I'm going to say if order complete date is null, not mul, null, all right, then we're returning this answer. Otherwise, we're just going to return a blank. All right, looks good, no errors. I'm going to hit OK. And yep, well, we'll know in a second. I see a whole bunch of nulls, but I'm pretty sure the data is there. So I'm going to close and apply, and I'll be right back. And by the way, if you are following along, then make sure you have the file from learnpowerbi.com/download. All right, so now we have in the fields the work order age. So let's put that on here. And I usually like looking at things. Oh, did that work? No. Okay, let me try that again. Drag and drop. And I often like looking at things in a table. Great. Sometimes by default, you drag something and it shows a different measure. And I already know that there is a problem because I did this when I was practicing this as well, which is you notice that the sorting is wrong and I forgot to change this to a number. So let's go back to our query editor and I'm going to change this to a number. So work order, go back, and age, I can see from this icon over here. Actually, a lot of other fields need to be changed, but we can ignore those. We're focused on this. So we're going to switch this to a whole number. Age looks good now, but of course, we're looking for the count of items by age. So I'm going to add the order count. By the way, that's a really simple formula, count rows. And now here's the thing here. Now we can see the order count by age, but there are two things going on. For one, we probably, so the ones which have been closed are showing up in this bucket. Now we can leave it as that. There are lots of ways to filter. We can say that age is not blank. We can say that order complete date has to be blank. But since we're doing this in the query editor, I'm just going to go back and add a cleaner column, which will be the work status. So work order, and I'll just go back here, add column, custom column. And I'll say work order status. And it's going to be really simple, similar to the other one. And it'll say if the order complete date is null, then it is open. Else it's closed. Does that look good? Oh, the equal sign. Okay, that looks good. Work order status. Open and closed. And let's try again. So now I have a little bit of a cleaner column that I can use, work order status, and I can add this to the page or I can add this to a specific filter. In this case, I'm just going to add it to the page, and I'm going to say I only want to see the open items. And now that one is filtered out. Now, of course, we can visualize it just like that. So again, when I'm working with measures or things like that, I mean, this one is pretty simple, but I still like to work in table or matrix. And only then do I think about visualizing it. So in this case, let's just try a column chart. So you can see that we're not quite there yet. I mean, yes, it is showing order count by age, but that's not how we want to see it, right? We want to bin it or group these so we can have a cleaner view. Now that's thankfully really easy to do in Power BI. For that, we're going to go to the age column that we just added, click on the three dots here, and we're going to create a new group. That brings up this dialog box, and in this case, we're just going to leave it to default. Bin, you can explore the other options if you like, and I'm going to hit OK. And that is going to give you another column here. So let me leave this one as is. I'm going to make a copy, and the second graph, we're going to use the bins, and you're going to see the difference. So instead of age, I'm going to drag and drop the age bins over here, and you can see how this looks a whole lot cleaner, right? So you have, you know, kind of these different bins. Is it 0, 50, 100, 150? I mean, those are the labels, but, you know, the bins have, let's see, if you hover over that, it's, yeah, it's kind of an odd number, but still, you kind of get an idea of the age. Let's talk about what are the possible next steps you could do from here. All right, so I cleaned up the view a little bit, added some basic measures, and again, if you grab the file, you'll be able to examine some of these other measures. And one thing I realized is that the age, I can actually go and and edit that group, and the bin size, it does try to calculate it automatically based on the different values, but I realized that it's better to not have the bin size as this weird number 19. So I'm gonna just change that to 20. Hit OK, and that'll just give us cleaner boundaries. But again, we'll talk about the next steps, and I'll show you what else may be possible here. So this gives you the same view that I showed earlier with all the awesomeness that you can do. You can kind of click, filter, and so forth. Actually, let me fix one more thing. All right, so you notice that the filtering was a little different than if you go back to the beginning of the video, and that is controlled by edit interactions. So I'm not going to go into that, but notice that now the filtering works differently. It doesn't highlight, it actually filters this one. So that's great. So as we did earlier, you can kind of click and select and focus in on just the Germany items. And again, grab the file. Now let's talk about what else is possible. I'm not going to be able to cover this in this video. However, that is our plan for actually our advanced Power BI training program that we will be announcing soon. You can go to learnpowerbi.com/advanced if you're interested in that and find out more. But let's see some of the ideas that I had of what else could be done. Now, I love this data set, and I think it's super interesting. The first idea that I had was to, again, these bins are kind of awkward, and I really don't have it. When I build it for my client, it's usually more specific, and I would probably end up doing something like this. And notice that, you know, there are cleaner labels, 0 to 10, 10 to 30, and so forth. And notice something interesting here, that these bin gaps are not the same. And, you know, sometimes clients do want to see this way, so I want to have more flexibility. This one is 10 days, this one is 20 days, this one is 30, 30. And of course, I love doing this part, where you don't want to show a long tail. Like, you notice how in this graph, there's this one guy sitting out here, and imagine there were a few of these, and it's always hard to kind of select them or something, right? So I just want to say, you know what, 90 plus, and then they can click on it, and they can see the details and so forth, right? So kind of these customized bins, I love doing that. But then, of course, God, I don't remember now if I mentioned, but I think I did, where I talked about the approach that I just showed you, used columns in Query Editor. Right, another approach you can do is using measures, and it would be more powerful, but it is slightly more nuanced. But with that, you can show a trend, so you can show kind of how many orders were open at any given time over time, and you can see that something bad happened with this company, right? I mean, around May 2021, right? And not just that, maybe you can show the trend of the average age, and you can see kind of that spiked up as well. But this functionality, it's you can't do that with the approach that we showed in this video, but it's definitely possible in Power BI. Well, I hope you enjoyed that video, and I love answering your questions. So if you have any questions, just go to learnpowerbi.com/question or leave a comment below, and I'll get back to you. Take care. Power on.